This white line signifies the separation of the good guy forces and the bad guy forces.
I'm in the cockpit of an F-22 Raptor simulator at the Northrop Grumman facility at Linthicum. And despite my photographer's insistence to blow up something big, I'm getting a lesson from F-22 test pilot Dave Cooley.
But what you're going to have to do so you don't get shot is as you drop your bombs, you're going to have to come off to your right to stay out of the red circle.
The Raptor is a fifth-generation tactical fighter equipped with the latest technology. It's the most advanced aircraft in the world, and the radar system is made right here in Maryland.
Here in Maryland, we're talking about 12 suppliers and about 625 jobs that are affected by the F-22 program. I think that equates to somewhere near $400 million of economic impact each year.
Next month, President Obama will have to make a decision on extending production of the Raptor, which counts for lots of jobs across the country.
Right now, there's 95,000 jobs across the nation, and there's a capability here that's unprecedented in technology. We have not had a soldier, sailor, airman, or marine die from enemy aircraft fire since 1953. That's how long we've had air superiority. This is our capability to have air superiority for the next 30 to 40 years.
Stop it, and then we just pull on the stick a little bit and just try to keep us nice and level.
Back in the cockpit, Captain Rob was shooting down enemy aircraft and bombing targets. This is like playing with a $10 million Xbox. Rob Roblin, WBAL-TV, 11 News.